Good morning, dear student. I'm Mandeep Sani, and today I'm here with the lesson number 7 of your English Circle book. In this lesson, I will discuss the question answer of this lesson and the book work of this lesson. So without wasting a time, I think we should start. Lesson number 7, Mowgli enters the pack. Word meaning, first one is prepared. Prepared means got ready. The meaning of the prepared is got ready. Number 2 is nagged. I have also discussed this word with you while I was reading the chapter, right? So the meaning of the nagged is without clothes. Nagged means without clothes, right? Third number is cubs. The meaning of the cubs is young ones of lion, bear and wolf. Cubs means young ones of lion, bear and wolf. Number 4 is law. The meaning of the law is rule. R-U-L-E, rule. Law means rule. Now we will move towards our question answer, right? First one is, what did Father Wolf find? What did Father Wolf find? It's a very quite easy question. I know you have already studied the lesson, so that's why the answer of this question is very easy for you. So what is the answer for this question? What did Father Wolf find? The question is in the past form, so that's why I have used the second form of the find here, that is found, right? What did Father Wolf find? Answer is Father Wolf found a man cub. Father Wolf found a man cub, right? Second number is, why did Mother Wolf call the man cub Mowgli? The question is in the past form, so I will use the second form of the call here, that is called, why did Mother Wolf call the man cub Mowgli? Answer is, Mother Wolf called the man cub Mowgli because his skin was smooth and without hair. Just like that of a frog. Because Mowgli's skin was very smooth and there is no hair on his body. So that's why Mother Wolf called the man cub Mowgli. Right? I will repeat it again. Why did Mother Wolf call the man cub Mowgli? Answer is, Mother Wolf called the man cub Mowgli because his skin was smooth and without hair, just like that of a frog. Now we will move towards our question number 3. Why did Father and Mother Wolf take the cubs to the council circle? In this question, we have to give the answer about why did they take the cubs to the council circle? Why did Father and Mother Wolf take the cubs to the council circle? Right? Answer is, they took the cubs to the council circle so that the other wolves would see them and know them if they met them in the jungle. They took the cubs to the council circle because both the parents wanted to introduce their cubs with the rest of the wolves. So that's why they have taken their cubs to the council circle. I'm going to repeat it again. They took the cubs to the council circle so that the other wolves, so that the rest of the wolves would see them and know them if they met them in the jungle. They took the cubs to the council circle so that the other wolves would see them and know them if they met them in the jungle, right? They have taken their cubs to the council circle because they wanted to introduce their cubs with the rest of the wolf members. right? So they have taken their cups to the council circle. Number 4. How many animals had to speak for man cub? How many animals had to speak for the man cub? Now here you have to give the answer in the digits, right? And you have already studied the lesson, and this question is quite easy for you. And the answer of this question is, how many animals had to speak for man cub? The answer is, two animals had to speak for the man cub. Two animals had to speak for the man cub. The answer is two animals, right? Now we will move towards our question number 5. 5th is, who spoke for Mowgli? Who spoke for Mowgli? Now two animals had to speak for the man cubs, right? So who are these two animals? Now we have to give the name of the two animals here. Answer is, Bhalu and Bagheera spoke for Mowgli. Who spoke for Mowgli? Bhalu and Bagheera spoke for Mowgli, right? Who spoke for Mowgli? Bhalu and Bagheera spoke for Mowgli, right? Now, dear student, we have a bookwork of this lesson also, and we will also discuss the bookwork of this lesson, right? So, it is a page number 75, and I'm going to discuss the bookwork with you now. Here we are seeing some animals at the left side, and here is a blank space in your book, and you have to write the name of the babies here. You are seeing the animals at the left side and at the right side. Just in front of that animal, you have to write the name of the baby of that particular animal, right? So we will start from the first. In the first picture, you are seeing a dolphin. Dolphin is an animal, and the baby of the dolphin is called calf. Dolphin, calf. Second is bear. The young one of bear is called cub. The young one of bear is called cub. C-U-B, cub. Third one is duck. The young one of duck is called duckling. D-U-C-K, duck, L-I-N-G, ling, duckling. Duck, duckling. Number 4 is, you are seeing sheep in the picture, and the young one of sheep is called lamb. L-A-M-B, lamb, right? Number 5 is tiger. The young one of tiger is called cub. C-U-B, cub. 6th number is, you are seeing the frog here, right? The young one of the frog is called tadpole, right? 6th number is frog, and the young one of frog is called tadpole. Now, dear student, we will move towards our fill-ups. The fill-ups related to can or may word. Can. We use can when we are able to do something, and when we have some ability to do that particular word, and we use a can word there. And may, when we need some permissions to do that particular works, so we always use a word may there, right? So without wasting our time, I think we should start from the first. Dash, I please go to the washroom? Question mark at the end of the sentence. Now, this sentence contained the permission. So without permission you can't go to the washroom. So what we will use here, can or may? You need permission to go to the washroom. So we will use may here. May I please go to the washroom, right? Second one is dash, you pass me the plate, question mark. Now this sentence contains your ability. There is no permission contained in this sentence. Passing plate is depend upon your ability. Can you pass the plate or not? That is your ability. So we would put can here. So we will put can here. Can you pass me the plate? Third number is dash, you read this sentence aloud, question mark. Now this sentence is also contained your ability. Can you read this sentence aloud, right? Fourth number is dash, we come in. Now to go inside, to go further, you need the permission of a particular person. So what we will use here, we will use may here. May we come in. Fifth number is she dash dance very well. Now this sentence contained the ability of a particular girl. So it is the ability, it shows the ability of a girl. She can dance very well, right? Sixth number is dash, I sit here. To sit here, you need to take a permission of a person, right? So may is always used for permission. Sixth number is may I sit here, right? So now we will move towards our page number 75. Sorry, we are now at page number 76. The blanks with the missing letters from the boxes to make words from the lessons. First number is SU double blank ER, and according to this word you have to choose a suitable word from the boxes, and we will choose double M here according to this word. SU double MER. So I have used double M here. Now the word becomes summer. SU double MER, summer. Number two is SU double blank ENLY. Now according to this word, I will use double D here. SU double D ENLY, suddenly. That's called suddenly. Third number is LI double blank LE. According to this word, I will use double T here. LI double T LE, little. Number four is SHA double blank SHA double L. That's shell. Number five is SM double blank TH, SM double O smooth TH th, that is smooth th. Number six is SL double E, I have used double D from here. SL double E slee, PYP, that's sleepy. I'm going to repeat it again. Summer, suddenly, little, shell, smooth or sleepy, right? That's all about our lesson number 7's question answer and the book work. I hope you have understood the entire lesson. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.